we have been building a bridge with the gay lesbian community since the 78ers were mishandled by police back in the day. We have been participating in Mardi Gras for the last 20 years and haven't missed a year. And I would hate to see that this is the year that we are excluded because of the actions of one person that is not gay hate related. This is a crime of passion, we will allege. It is domestic related, we allege. And that would be a real travesty for this organisation to be excluded. It is an event on the calendar that we as an organisation look forward to participate in, but including many of my officers who seek approval to participate, who are also members of that community, and to shut the door on them would be, it would set us backwards.
Is it insensitive? Police officers have been charged with murder. Police officers have been charged with murder.
Yep.
Is historic, as Mr. Hudson just alluded to. Last year, a police officer allegedly tasered a 95-year-old woman. That was historic too. And on both occasions, it's taken days to publicly address this. Are there questions over your leadership?
No. And that's offensive. In fact, I've already said this morning, on Friday I was in budget estimates, which is a parliamentary hearing, sworn on oath, between 9 and 5.30 in the day. The accused handed himself in on Friday. He was charged on Friday. On Saturday morning, I attended the Sunrise event at Bronte Park in Marks Park to remember those gay men that were lost their lives there. I don't remember seeing too many media there, but I was there. The minister and I were there, along with many of the community. Yesterday morning, I spoke to Jesse's brother and father. This afternoon, I will meet with Luke's family. Last night, I was on the phone to Shane Patton from Victoria. I've been on the phone. Of course I'm doing my job, but I need to let my detectives do the job that I ask them to do.
Does part of your job, though, include addressing the public? And when you say it's offensive, this isn't just me.
So we're talking...
Wait a second.
Yeah.
This isn't just me with the court bubble.
Yeah.
This is coming from many of your officers to many of the journalists here. Where's the leadership? That is a constant theme from officers that we are speaking with as we seek to gather information.
That might be your sources. What I said to you was the accused handed himself on Friday and today is Monday.
Could you not leave budget estimates? Is that what you're saying?
That's right.
I'm sure you were notified. Were you notified?
I was notified in budget estimates.
And there's not by lunch break that you could have stepped out for the rest of the
year. It's a full day. Saturday, I told you where I was Saturday and I'd been... Sunday's paper, I made my apology, which I had been working on, and also released a statement. Well, I've got a whole crew here today. How many would I have had on Saturday? Where were you on Saturday?
Were the media notified of that on Saturday?
What's
that? Were the media notified about that event on Saturday?
I didn't own the event, so I presume so. There was some media there. There was a picture of me on the news, Channel 9 News.
Through
so
there,
yeah.
Because we were found by someone else, not through the police department.
I understand it was an event... hosted by a surf club in partnership with ACON and others, and they had some arrangement about filming. Well, I think they had some private arrangement for a documentary. So.
Is this not about you being proactive, though, and calling a press conference to specifically tackle this issue head on? A police officer is alleged to have murdered two people.
And we still don't have two bodies. We are still looking for two bodies.
Correct.
And I'm yet to speak to Luke's family. Two bodies, and really, this is really about an appeal, because as Mr. Hudson has said, it is unlikely that he is actually in the bodies are in the Bungoni area. They could be anywhere between here and Newcastle or beyond. We really do need people with any information to come forward. We have many Crime Stoppers reports reporting white van near water, etc. And we will work through those one by one, but that still remains today, a week later, as Mr. Hudson said, we still have Jesse and Luke missing.
Commissioner, is it insensitive for police to march in the parade given the failings of the force exposed in the inquiry into hate crimes?
I think that this is a real opportunity for the community to embrace us, given the progress we have made. I can't change the events of 40 years ago, 30 years ago, or even 10 years ago, or last week. But I spoke to the president of ACON on Saturday, And we do look forward to collaborating with the community to move forward. And I think us participating is part of that.
Do you accept as a community?
When someone asked you not to participate, would you respect that request? And
if who asked me not to?
If Mardi Gras organising committee
asked. If they asked me not to participate, I'll respect that. But the police force, I think that's a conversation we'll have to have. Because as I said, I think it's an important symbolic event for the community and my organisation. And after 20 years, to stop now would be, I think, a travesty.
Can you acknowledge, though, the emotions of very raw in the gay community at the moment, particularly because the accused marched in the parade last year? It's a very distressing time for them. I'll correct you.
I don't think it was last year. I think it was before. And we will obviously it's coming up on Saturday. And if the community is that incensed, but I do think that it sets us back because of the actions of one officer on the back of the Special Commission of Inquiry, that we need to focus our efforts on that one person who is accused, who is charged, who is before the court.
Justice Sackart found that police were adversarial or unnecessarily defensive in their conduct during the inquiry. Do you accept that?
As I said at the beginning, we will make a response to the Special Commission report and recommendations by the due date on the 31st of March. But I think to your question and point, the fact that I made an apology that was printed on Sunday goes to the fact that we can do things better.
But during the inquiry, were police uncooperative?
I can't speak for every single witness at the inquiry. In fact, as I understand it, there were witnesses who were no longer serving police officers and there are witnesses that are, and there were volumes and volumes. There were over 200 summonses issued. So it was a huge inquiry, four volumes, over 5,000 pages of documents. In the report, there is a lot to consider. And if it is that we as the current organisation were difficult to deal with, I'll accept that. But I can't account for other witnesses or former officers on how they behaved.
Is it against the rules for a police officer to upload social media photos of themselves wearing a firearm?
I'll have to refer to our policy on that. And I don't know the circumstances. I presume you're talking about the photo when he's dressed in black with a firearm on his side. I don't know, and that will form part of the investigation, whether he was on duty, off duty, or the circumstances.
Okay, but culturally, is it frowned upon?
I would think so, but and we can deal with that. I think he's facing murder charges right now.
Why you made that apology on Sunday specifically? I mean, of all the weekends.
Well, I'd been working on it for some time. I had actually made, through connections, I had made an approach to make that apology at the Sunrise event, and that others spoke. And as I said at the beginning, it's just time. It is time.
Thank you.